Hello everyone, let us continue towards the second kind of share, that is the preference shares. Basically, the capital raised through the preference shares is preference share capital. But now the question is, what do we mean by the preference shares? Preference shares are the shares who are enjoying a preferential position over the equity shares. That means, or the we can say the holder of preference share is enjoying preferential position over the equity shareholders. That means shares is just like share, but if a preference is given to any kind of share, that will be called a preference share, or the holder will be called a preference share holder. Now the question is, what kind of preference? The preference is in relation to receiving a fixed rate of dividend. When the company earns the profit and it distributes the dividend, first preference is given to the preference shareholders, or I may say that to whom the preference is given, that will be called the preference shareholder. The shares to whom preference is not given, they are paid at last, they are called the equity shares. So receiving a fixed rate of dividend out of net profits of a company before any dividend is declared to equity shareholder is one of the feature of preference share. And the second one is, when the claims are to be settled down, that means at the time of liquidation, that if the shares, they get again the preference over the equity shares, that means after settling all the claims of the creditors, what is being left from the left amount the shareholder is paid, that is called the preference shareholder. That means in a layman language, we can say that both of the times, when at the time of declaring or giving the payment in relation to dividend, or when at the time of final winding up or at the time of liquidation, the kind of shares get the preference is known as the preference shares. Preference shares have a feature of debentures and equity shares. Even you have not studied about the debentures, in our next slides we will study about the debentures. So debentures are those which bear a fixed rate of return. In the same way that preference shareholders also bear the fixed rate of return, as well as that preference shares, but the preference shares do not enjoy any kind of voting right, which is being enjoyed by the equity shares. So preference shares means the shares which get preference over the dividend and the final amount. This is called the preference shares. Let us study about the merit of preference shares. So preference shares, as I said, that they are being paid at a fixed rate of dividend. So their return of rate of return is fixed and their investment is safe. These are being bought by those shares. Preference shares are being bought by those investors who want a fixed rate of return with comparatively low risk. As I said you, that equity shares are the riskier shares. If something is being left at the end, they are being provided to the equity shareholders. If nothing is left, they are not given anything. So preference shareholders are useful for those they want to bear lesser risk. It does not affect the control equity shareholders over the management because they are not having any voting right. And payment of fixed rate of dividend to the preference shares may enable a company to declare higher rate of dividend for equity shareholders in good times. Suppose The company has earned lots of profit or some extra profit this year. As preference shares, they will be getting fixed rate of dividend. There will be no change. Chahe preference shares ke liye company jyada profit earn kare ya kam earn kare, unko fixed rate of dividend mil jayega. Lekin agar company ko higher profits hote hain, achhe profits hote hain, in that situation jo hai wo bacha hua amount, left amount will go in the pocket of equity shares. So ये प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स के इक्विटी शेयर्स वालों के लिए एक बेनिफिट हो गया प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स का इशू करना. प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स हैव अ प्रेफरेंशियल राइट, ये तो हम पढ़ ही चुके हैं, दैट प्रेफरेंशियल राइट है एट द टाइम ऑफ लिक्विडेशन और एट द टाइम ऑफ डिविडेंड. प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स डज नॉट क्रिएट एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ चार्ज. मीन्स अभी नेक्स्ट लेक्चर्स में वी विल स्टडी दैट डिवेंचर्स इशू करने पर कंपनी की फिक्स एसेट्स ऑटोमेटिकली मोर्टगेज हो जाती हैं. तो प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स की जो प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स के केस में ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स में एसेट जो है वो ऑटोमेटिकली मोर्टगेज नहीं होती हैं. तो ये कंपनी के लिए बेनिफिट हो गया दैट कंपनी कैन एन्जॉय दीज फिक्स एसेट्स एंड कैन यूज दीज एसेट्स इन अनदर. Limitations of preference shares are not suitable for those investors who are willing to take risk and interested in higher returns. Because if you recall, more the risk, more the profits, lesser the risk, lesser the profits or returns, we can say. So preference shareholders, they are not suitable for those investors who want to take risk and they are interested in higher returns. Preference capital dilutes the claim of equity shareholder over the assets of the company. Means, what does this mean? It means that if in the cases of emergencies that company has to sell the assets, the first the preference shareholders will be paid. If something will be left, it will be given to the shareholders, otherwise equity shareholders will not get anything. The third one is rate of dividend on preference shares is generally higher than the rate of interest on debentures. Means agar hum debentures per 7-8% or 9% इंटरेस्ट पे कर रहे हैं तो प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स पर 10% 11% दैट रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड इज बीइंग पेड. बट रिमेंबर दैट दिस डिविडेंड विल बी पेड इफ कंपनी अर्न्स द प्रॉफिट. इफ ए कंपनी इज नॉट अर्निंग द प्रॉफिट then the dividend will not be paid. That means these shares will not be very attractive to the investors. The dividend paid is not deductible from profit as expense. Isiliye jo hai wo, there is no tax saving in the case of interest on loans. डिबेंचर्स पर अगर हम इंटरेस्ट हमने इंटरेस्ट पे किया तो टोटल इनकम में से डिबेंचर्स का इंटरेस्ट माइनस हो जाएगा, रेस्ट ऑफ द इनकम पर हमें टैक्स पे करना पड़ेगा. लेकिन ऐसा नहीं कि प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स के डिविडेंड में प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स पर हमें डिविडेंड पे कर दिया जाए तो वो हमारी इनकम में से माइनस हो जाएगा. इट्स नॉट लाइक इन द केस ऑफ प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स. Let us continue towards the types of preference. Wherever I will talk about the types of preference shares, there are three types of preference shares. One is cumulative and non-cumulative, other one is participating and non-participating, another one is convertible and non-convertible. Cumulative means ikattha hona, means in any year if the company is not able to pay that dividend is being cumulated for the next year. Means if a company is issuing cumulative preference shares, to in that case company ne ek saal dividend nahi diya to it will pay in the next year. But opposite in the case of non-cumulative mein company dividend if not paid in a particular year, to it will not pay the dividend in next year. Participating and non-participating, it says that preference shares अगर कोई सरप्लस प्रॉफिट में अपना राइट है, अगर सरप्लस प्रॉफिट में, दैट मींस आफ्टर मेकिंग ऑल द पेमेंट्स डिवेंचर होल्डर को, प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर को, इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर को पे करने के बाद बावजूद अगर कंपनी के पास अभी कोई भी सरप्लस है, इन दैट केस उस सरप्लस में प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स भी अपना राइट रखते हैं, तो दिस विल बी कॉल्ड पार्टिसिपेटिंग प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स। इफ नॉट, दिस विल बी कॉल्ड नॉन पार्टिसिपेटिंग प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स। ये इश्यू की टर्म में ही डिसाइड हो जाता है कि प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स विल बी पार्टिसिपेटिंग एंड नॉन पार्टिसिपेटिंग, कमुलेटिव एंड नॉन कमुलेटिव, एज वेल एज कन्वर्टिबल एंड नॉन कन्वर्टिबल। कन्वर्टिबल, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द कन्वर्टिबल एंड नॉन कन्वर्टिबल, तो कन्वर्टिबल मीन्स विच कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू इक्विटी शेयर्स और द डिबेंचर्स। तो बाय द नेम वी आर एबल टू गेट कन्वर्टिबल प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स आर दोज विच कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू इक्विटी शेयर्स। मीन्स प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स वापिस करके उसके बदले में अगर इक्विटी शेयर्स मिल जाएंगे तो दिस विल बी कॉल्ड कन्वर्टेबल प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स। अदरवाइज दिस विल बी, इफ नॉट, इफ सच कंडीशन इज नॉट, देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड नॉन कन्वर्टेबल प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स। तो इट इज ऑल फॉर द डे। थैंक यू।